Welcome back, YIM listeners. You are now listening and tuned in to YIM, and this is Jason. I'm going to give you another daily message today for you to get you going through your day. Excuse my voice. I just woke up, but you know when you get that morning, morning cold when it goes away. So, that's what I got. So, excuse my voice. All right. So today's message is going to be, it's actually going to be a story today, and it's called The Devil's Soup Bowl. The Devil's Soup Bowl. And this is a story that I came across. I actually had a different message for you, but the Holy Spirit, how he works is he takes you and leads you and guides you to where he wants you to go and what he wants you to say. So the message today is about the Devil's Soup Bowl. I'll read the story to you, and then we'll go into the scriptures. Alright. Says, while my son-in-law and I were hiking in a state park last summer, we noticed a trail marker that pointed towards something called the Devil's Soup Bowl. Intrigued, we took off for this geologic formation. As we went, we joked about the kind of soup we might find in the bowl. When we arrived, we discovered it to be a large sunken area of land, something like a deep lake without any water in it. We were rather disappointed to discover that the Devil's Soup Bowl was filled with nothing but trees and weeds. The Devil's Soup Bowl is a perfect name for a formation that offers something of interest but ends up providing nothing. Because the devil is a deceiver, his menu is a bowl of tricks that delivers only empty promises and broken dreams. Satan began his deceitful works for substituting nothing for something when he tricked Eve into the Garden of Eden, and he has not changed his plan. He tried his deceit on Jesus, but the Lord resisted and the devil left him. So how do you know if you are being offered one of Satan's lies? Test new ideas with scripture. Consult with people you trust to be godly and wise, and pray. Don't fall for the devil's bowl of empty lies. And the poem reads, Satan's a liar, deceiving all men. Subtly, he causes their fall into sin. But his sly methods, we surely can know, looking to Jesus wherever we go. Satan offers nothing but tricks and deceit. Okay, listeners, so let's look at a few scriptures in the Bible about how Satan is deceitful and tries to trick us. In Matthew's 1 through 11, he tries three different attempts with Jesus, trying to trick him. He know that Jesus just fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, so he know Jesus is hungry, wants to eat something, so he comes to Jesus with his first trick. You know, if you're the Son of God, why don't you change this stone into bread? Okay, and what happens? Jesus like, no. He immediately resists the devil's response and is like, no, it is written. It is written that man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Then the devil took him to a holy city and stood him in the highest point of a temple. And then he told the Son of God, he said, well, if you're the Son of God, then throw yourself down. For it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against the stone. Now, if you read this passage carefully, what it's saying is that you see how the devil tries to trick Jesus, and now he adds, it is written. For it is written. So he's trying to say that God wrote that what he's saying for Jesus to do. He's a deceitful liar. And he feeds on everything that he can, and he tries to advance. Each time he attempts to give you something and tempt you with it, the next time he tempts you, he's going to try harder. So now what he's adding in his little slick remark is, for it is written, to try to trick Jesus into thinking, oh, well, if it's written, because I said it is written also, then it must be true. That's a lie. The devil is nothing but a liar. And of course, we know Jesus, of course, rejected him again. Do not put the Lord your God to the test. That's what it says. Jesus doesn't have to do that, because that is not what God told him to do. So again, the devil took Jesus to the highest mountain and showed him all the kingdoms. All the kingdoms of the world. And he said to Jesus, he said, I will give you all this if you bow down and worship me. Now the devil wants the Son of God to bow down and worship him for kingdoms. Jesus already has all the kingdoms in the world because his Father created them. But again, Satan is trying to trick Jesus into bowing down to him and try to give him something, which in the end will be nothing. And that's what we have to understand, that the devil's gifts are temporary, but God's gifts are permanent. So with the devil's soup bowl, if you look at it, a bowl in your kitchen has a deep empty space for you to put something in it. If you put nothing in the bowl will continue to be empty. So for the devil's soup bowl, it will always be empty. There is nothing you will ever get out of a bowl that the devil has given you. And even with the name, the devil's soup bowl, don't be intrigued. Don't be excited about it. Don't even be curious about it. But it happens. We see a restaurant called the Satan's Kitchen, or Devil's Firestone, or the Devil's Market, or the Enemy's Corner. We shouldn't be intrigued. We shouldn't want to go and be curious about these places. We shouldn't even want to see what's inside. We shouldn't want to even be around a place called the Devil's Kitchen. Because if someone has the audacity to name a place like that, then in some way, shape, or form, the devil has been invited. Because now they're calling his name to get your attention to come into their kitchen. Come into his kitchen. So trust me, he's there. Because I guarantee you, Jesus is not going to walk into any place called the devil's kitchen. And we have to understand and we have to know and see the devil's tricks. See, now he's advanced so well that he's disguising himself as people. He's disguising himself as shop owners and friends and even in family members. He's disguising himself. And you have to be able to discern and know where he is at all times so you can walk away from him. And when he tempts you, you can tell him no, so he will flee. The devil has many tricks. And if you're not careful and you're not have a discerning spirit and you don't allow the Holy Spirit to move in you, you will fall for his tricks and you'll be right inside of that empty bowl with him. So the devil's soup bowl is an empty bowl that has nothing in it. There's no promise in it. There's no everlasting life. Be careful, listeners. Be careful of the routes that you take. Be careful of the places you walk in. Be careful of the people you meet and shake hands with. Be careful with the people that you talk to on a regular basis. Be careful of the friends you keep around you. Because the enemy has costumes for days and days to come. And he will always disguise himself to trick you into walking into a trap. So you have to make sure you are guarded up and have your armor on. And allow Jesus and the Holy Spirit to walk with you. And do not be tempted by his tricks. Because he is evil. He is a liar. He is deceitful. And his only objective and motive for your life is to kill, steal, and destroy it. He wants one or the other. Either he's going to kill you, or he's going to steal your soul, or he's going to destroy you. That's his only motive for your life. There's nothing else, nothing more, nothing less, nothing in front or behind it. That's his only objective for your life. Don't be foolish. Don't walk into his traps. Be cautious. Be spiritually led. And allow the Holy Spirit to work in you and teach you the right path to go. Because the devil's soup bowl is not a place I would want to eat at ever in my life. So listeners, I encourage you. I encourage you to stay and have faith. I encourage you to pray. I encourage you to just follow the word. Use the word as your sword. When the enemy's trying to attack, use the word as your sword. All you got to do is open the Bible, find the scripture and read it. And I guarantee you he's going to run away. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for opening our eyes that we can see. We thank you for showing us the right direction to go. We thank you for continuing to be a part of our lives, God. We thank you for just being you, God. We thank you for being the God Almighty that you are. We ask, Father God, that you just guard us up from it. That you give us that discerning spirit that we need to not be led into the enemy's traps. That we are not led into the kitchen where the devil is cooking. That we do not end up in the shopping market where the devil is selling. And that we do not end up in the house where the devil lives, God. We ask that we are led by your spirit and your spirit alone, God. That we only end up in the places where God is invited. Because we know that if we are there, we are safe. And we will have everlasting life as long as we believe in your Son, God. And we thank you, Father, for it. We ask, Father God, just continue to be a part of our lives, be in our lives. Continue to guide us and walk with us, God. Continue to order our steps, Father God, that we do not lean to our own understanding, and that we stay strong and confident and encouraged and know that with you, Father God, we can do all things as long as we just call on your name. And Father God, we ask that you just help us and condition our minds to where we can not allow the enemy to tempt us and win, because we got the victory, Father God, if we just call on your name and read your word, then the enemy has no choice but to flee as long as we resist him by calling your name, God. And we just thank you today, Father God. And again, God, we come to you today asking for your forgiveness for our sins, our known sins and unknown sins that we may have committed against you, Father God. We ask for your forgiveness, God, for any impure thoughts we may have in our minds that try to control us. And we ask, God, that you just forgive us for them, God. And that we have the strength and power to forgive others for any wrongdoings that were done to us, God, that we can make it into your kingdom and receive all that you have for us, God. And we just thank you, God, because we know that with faith you have done it for us, Father God. And God, we will always continue to give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. And it is in your perfect and precious Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. So I thank you, listeners, for listening. And the song for today is by Mally Music. And the song is called I Hate You. This is an awesome song. It's a little fast beat. This is something that he actually wrote to let the devil know how he feels about him. So I hope you guys enjoy it. And God bless.
Like no weapon formed against me. real though, I'm tired of this mess. Sick of this thing, better we all call flesh. Oh, let go, spread it up, better do what they do. And I'ma sprinkle all the edges on you, yes. I hate you trying to make me do wrong when I'm right. I hate you trying to speak up to my new life. You wanted to kill me, but it ain't gonna I'ma make it all this head. I hate you, I refuse to follow you when fair. Grandmama and you. You say that I just can't stand. You are so perfect. You so I wrote this song. Yes, I hate you. Wanna fight you? Can't tell you how much I don't like you. A deceiver and a liar. You get on my last nerve. I despise you. You stupid and simple, trying to defile me. I'm a temple. Now I'm fed up.